Good evening sa lahat.
Alam niyo po, napakahirap magtanong sa isang former president na mahal ng maraming tao, pero kailangan po nating magtanong para sa kapakanan ng mga taong bayan at para mabigyan ng linaw ang mga isyo sa extrajudicial killing. Mr. President, Sir Chair, kilala po ba ninyo si Mr. Jamie Guban o pamilyar po ba kayo sa pangalan niya at si Mr. Mark Taguba?
It does not ring a bell.
Hindi niyo po kilala si Mr. Jamie Guban at si Mr. Taguba. Kasi po, according to Mr. Jamie Guban at Mr. Mark Taguba, sangkot po si Davao Congressman Honorable Pulong Duterte at si Attorney Manz Carpio na inyong manugang at si Mr. Michael Young na inyong Presidential Economic Advisor sa nahuling 1 billion worth of shabu sa magnetic lifters sa Port of Manila at sa smuggling ng mga metal cylinders na may lamang 6.4 billion na halaga ng shabu. Ngayon po, Mr. Chair, Mr. President, may alam po ba kayo sa insidenteng ito? At nabalitaan niyo po ba ito?
Wala po. But kung totoo yan nangyari, I would strongly suggest that yung anak ko at yung minention mo, that's my son-in-law.
Yes po.
To file a case, and I'm urging the prosecutors to do their best to file a case in court. That is the remedy. Unless patayin natin, but that is not anak ko. The best remedy is really to go public, expose them, and file the case in court, just like what you're doing now, so that they will be made answerable for their misdeeds in this planet.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Thank you, Mr. President. Ito pong sinatanong ko po kanina ay according to Mr. Jamie Guban and Mr. Mark Taguba. Next question po.
Yung iyo is according to two persons?
Ayon po kay Mr. Guban at ayon po kay Mr. Pulong Duterte, Mr. Jamie Guban po
nandito ba si Guban?
Wala po siya. Mr. Jamie Guban po is a former Customs Intelligence Officer at si Mr. Taguba is custom broker involved sa smuggling of shabu. Si Colonel Acierto po ay nasa Zoom. Pwede po muna natin siyang tanungin. Mr. Kerr?
I'm sorry, Congressman Tevez. What was the question?
Pwede po ba nating tanungin si Colonel Acierto dahil po siya ay nasa Zoom regarding po rito sa mga tinatanong ko po kanina kaya former president?
You can ask questions to Colonel Acierto. You have 10 minutes, Congressman Tevez.
The names of my son and they must come here and testify in person. Huwag yung Zoom na Zoom. Hindi pwede yung Zoom na Zoom because that is not a standard of justice. Hindi pwede yung ganun. You know, ang pangalan ng anak ko, pati yung son-in-law ko, so I will object. Bakit tayo mag-zoom-zoom dito? Dalhin mo dito yung tao. Give the names of those persons to the committee so that they can subpoena the idiots the other around. O dalhin mo dito, paupuin mo so that the committee members and the chairman can ask questions. And
Mr.
we can
Mr.
feed
President.
Our questions with him so that
Mr. Chair.
Mr. President, with all due respect, last Monday when we canceled the invitation supposedly for today's committee hearing, and then yesterday we decided that we proceed again, no, with this committee hearing, we have sent out we were in a press conference, and I mentioned in the press conference that those who want to attend as our resource person for today's committee hearing is welcome. And that is why several of our resource persons are here. Senator Leila De Lima, Father Flavio Villanueva, Senator Antonio Trillanes, and the others, no? And former Congressman Nery Colmenares is also present. It is because perhaps they heard that there was a invitation that we stated during the press conference. Now, ginagawa din po sa amin ang when we ask questions to our resource persons via Zoom, it is allowed, no, under our rules na they can be asked questions and they can also participate in a committee hearing. However, in this case of Colonel Acerto, para lang po to set the record straight, siya po ay wala po dito sa Pilipinas. Hindi po namin malocate kung nasaan po siya. But when we offered and invited them to join the committee hearing, he has signified this intention to join this committee hearing via Zoom. And since the rules allow that, Your Honors, Mr. President, pinayagan po namin. Yan po ang nakasaad sa rules ng Rules of Procedure Governing Inquiries in Aid of Legislation sa 19th Congress po. Just for the information of the former president. So, kaya po siguro, nandiyan dyan yung kung nagtanong po si Congressman Bong Teves, kung maaari po bang tanungin si Colonel Acerto. I don't know if he's still online. If he's still online, pwede niyo po siyang tanungin. Just for the information of the former president. Thank you. Please proceed, Congressman Teves.
May I ask to Colonel Acerto kung nandiyan pa?
Comsec, Secretariat, would you know if there's Colonel Acerto in the Zoom? Kung online ba? If Colonel Acerto, kayo po ba'y nandiyan dyan?
Yes, sir. Dito po ako.
Sige po. Congressman Bong Teves, you have 8 more minutes na lang na iwan sa inyo.
Colonel Acerto, good evening.
Mr. Chair, you have to satisfy the requirements of the law or regulation. Tell us why you are not here. Are you sick? Are you half dead? Are you incapacitated? Because you will deprive the other parties participating in this hearing the right to answer,
okay,
or give questions.
Thank you for that suggestion, Mr. President. Yes, Colonel Acerto, bakit po kayo nag-online? Bakit po wala kayo dito physically present dito sa bulwagang ito?
Sorry po, hindi ko po maintindihan.
Bakit po?
Paano po yung audio?
Ulitin ko po, Colonel Acerto. Pwede po bang malaman bakit wala po kayo dito sa physically dito sa bulwagang ito nang sa ganon ay kayo po'y makaharap dito sa committee hearing ng Quadcom? Pwede po bang malaman kung anong rason?
Ako po ay, Mr. Chairman, ako po ay matatago dahil ako po ay pinapapatay ni dating Pangulong Duterte dahil sa ginawa kong report tungkol kay Michael Young at Alan Lim.
Eh, kung pinapatay kita, bakit buhay ka pa ngayon? Buko pala.
1 minute suspension.
Mr. Chairman.
1 minute suspension. 1 minute suspension. So I think things have cooled down. Hearing is now resumed.
Mr. Chairman, just a point of clarification, Mr. Chairman.
Congressman Paduano.
Mr. Chairman, the former president has been told by this representation twice that he should wait to be recognized by the chairman. And he keep on talking without being recognized by the chairman. So what's the pleasure of this committee and the chairman in regards to that?
Well, it's probably an oversight on my part, Your Honor, but you know, it's not very easy to manage a committee hearing like this since mainit po ang usapin, kaya as much as possible, no, we are trying to cool things down, no, especially kapag tumataas na po ang temperatura. Kaya nga, if there were lapses on my part, I would like to ask for a consideration from my colleagues, especially my co-chairs, with respect to the rulings of this chair. So, ang akin lamang po, naitanong po kanina kung bakit nasa online o nasa Zoom, ako po'y as much as I can, I explained, no, kung ano po yung basihan. At ano po ang ating rules tungkol, ano po ating batayan tungkol dito, kaya po nabanggit ko yan kanina. But if there are any rulings that you wish to for the chair to make, please manifest and I will try to consider whatever the requests of my colleagues. So yun lang ang aking gustong isagot sa inyong katanungan,
Mr. Chairman. Again, this is just a manifestation. I just want to remind the former president that please do not answer queries or talk unless otherwise you are being recognized by the chairman. Please let other resource person or members of the committee finish their statement or query. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, thank you, Congressman Paduano.
Yes, sir. I apologize.
Your apologies is taken. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Please proceed, Congressman Tevez. You only have 6 minutes.
Colonel Acerto, good evening. Ayon po kay Mr. Jimmy Guban, kayong dalawa po, Colonel Acerto, ay naging biktima sa mapya ng Davao at base naman kay Mr. Taguba. Sabi niya ay pinasilitate niya ang entry ng mga Cebu shipment dahil sa influence at protection ng isang Davao group. May idea ka po ba rito, Colonel Acerto?
Pwede bang ano, yung aking, ating technical, ano, wala pong audio, paki-check naman po. Secretariat, can you please make sure that the audio is working?
Mr. Chair, may I question this anomaly of taking a testimony with video of a person on the basis of his story only? Dapat to dito, that person, if he has something to say against or for anybody, must be required to attend here and tell his story. Mahirap po yan because that is not a standard, a fair standard of justice. Sulo nila pagkatapos tapos ng istorya. So, his story becomes gospel truth. O what about yung mga tao tinatamaan niya na totoo hindi? How can you now confront or ask question? How can you now redeem your name, your honor, if hayaan mo ng ganon
sa mga
testimony? They should be required to attend.
Mr. President, kanina po piniliwanag ko po kung ano po ang ating batayan at ating basihan sa pagpayag po natin na magkaroon po kami ng mga resource persons via Zoom, no? Tinanong po kanina ni Congressman Bongtebes kung bakit nasa Zoom si Colonel Acierto, at tinanong ko rin po kung ano po yung ano, at hindi pa po yata siya nakakasagot doon sa katanungan yon. I do understand, Mr. President, yung inyong punto, no? And I cannot not allow the resource person via Zoom to participate in this committee hearing because under our rules, it is allowed. But I will guarantee you that whatever the resource persons via Zoom will make, this is taken, this should be under oath, number one. And number two, we can dispute whatever claims he has or he will make before this committee, Mr. President.
How about the guy talking there kanina? Was he under oath?
Yes, Mr. President. He's been a constant resource person of the committee.
Yes, but
Mr. Chairman,
he has made other statements.
Mr. Chairman, can I move for...
Taken already.
Mr. Chairman, can I move for 1 minute, please?
1 minute suspension.
There are accusations made here. Deny to...
Hearing is resumed. Congressman Bongtebes.
Mr. Chair, pwede bang mag-manifest muna na sana habang nagsasalita po ako, wala mo ng interruption?
Okay, please, to all the members and our resource persons, please take note of the request of Congressman Bongtebes. So you got earlier you have 7 minutes, now you have 6.5 minutes. Please proceed.
Mababawasan yung oras ko eh. Colonel Acierto, nandiyan pa ba siya? Nasa Zoom pa rin siya? If wala, may I ask Mr. Chair to former President, kilala niyo po ba si Colonel Acierto?
Hindi ako.
Ano po ang sagot?
I don't know him. Hindi ako.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Chair. Kasi kanina, habang nasa Zoom at bilang naputol, tinanong po natin si Colonel Acierto kung bakit siya wala sa Pilipinas? Ang sagot niya, dahil siya ay ipapapatay.
Saan po siya?
Wala sa Pilipinas.
Kaya nga, where is he?
Hindi po natin.
Baka alam mo.
Okay, anyway, tutuloy ko na lang po. According to Mr. President, hindi niya kilala si Jimmy Cuban at hindi niya kilala si Mark Taguba. Pero si Jimmy Cuban po ay a former Custom Intelligence Officer at si Mark Taguba is Custom Broker na siya po ang nagsabi na may nahuling 11 billion worth of shabu through magnetic lifters sa Port of Manila. At ang kasama doon po ay si Congressman Pulong Duterte, Attorney Manscarpio, at Michael Young. Okay. Ngayon, according po sa ating former President, Mr. Chair, kailangan daw nating ma-invite o ma-physical na tanungin yung mga involved na persons. Kaya may I manifest that we invite next hearing Mr. Jimmy Cuban and Mark Taguba and also Congressman Pulong Duterte and Attorney Manscarpio para personal niyang matanong kung ano ang sinasabi ni Mr. Jimmy Cuban at ni Mr. Mark Taguba regarding sa sinasabi na nahuli sa Port of Manila na 11 billion worth of shabu at $6.4 billion metal cylinders worth of drugs.
Mr. Chairman,
Before I recognize Congressman Paduano, there's a request of Congressman Bong Teves to invite the persons he mentioned and COMSEC, the whole secretariat of the Quadcom, please take note and send invitations to the persons mentioned by Congressman Bong Teves. Before Cong Teves, before you proceed, yes.
Chairman, just with due respect to Congressman Teves, this is just a matter of clarification. Kasi po, if giving due courtesy to a colleague in the House, we should not invite, I think it's just proper, Mr. Chairman, that we should not invite Congressman Pulong Duterte. He should be present voluntarily if he wants. Just giving due courtesy, Mr. Chairman, to a colleague in the House.
The COMSEC is directed to send notice to our colleague, Congressman Pulong Duterte, to attend the next committee hearing of the Quadcom.